Today we are going to see how to design a components when subjected to reverse stresses. Now, during earlier sessions, we have seen what do you mean by stress concentration, factors affecting the stress concentration, how to reduce the stress concentration, then knot sensitivity, then how to measure or how to determine the endurance limit by using laboratory test or rotating beam machine, then approximate estimation of endurance limit, that is AC is equal to K into KB, KC, KD into AC dash. In relationship between AC dash and ultimate tensile strengths for different materials. Even though endurance limit modifying factor or derating factor, that is surface finish factor, size factor, reliability factor, modified stress concentration factor, thermal factor, or sometimes miscellaneous factor. All these things we have already covered. Today we are going to see how to design the components subjected to reverse stresses. And before that, I have already explained the different models of the fluctuating load. The main objective of today's session, design for finite and infinite life when components subjected to reverse stresses. Now here, you know very well, there are two types, or you can say two cases of reverse stresses. First, in general, fluctuating stresses. So while designing the component subjected to fatigue failure or subjected to varying load or fluctuating load, so you have to take the care of these two cases. Case number one is the component subjected to completely reverse stress. And second one, component subjected to fluctuating stress. Reverse stress means during a half cycle, you will get tensile stress, again another one half compressive and magnitude is same. That means sigma min is equal to zero. That's why reverse stress. That means plus 50, component may be subjected plus 50 Newton load, then minus 50 Newton load, likewise in one cycle. That is reverse stress. Then second one is the component subjected to fluctuating. That means variation in load. Load does not remain constant. If within one cycle, you will find the variation. Tensile stress may be 60 Newton, compressive stress may be 30 Newton during one cycle, like this. So, in earlier session also, we have seen the different, the models or sinusoidal models. Now, we look at this first one. When components subjected to fluctuating or alternating stresses, how to design such a component? And for that purpose, I have already explained this, the sinusoidal model to you. You know very well on y-axis stress, x-axis time, then for fluctuating and alternating stress, there is two important things, that is sigma min and sigma amplitude, or amplitude stress value, that we have to find out while solving the problem associated with fluctuating or alternating stresses. Sigma min means 1/2 sigma max plus sigma min. When here you will find from 0 to up to this, this is maximum stress, up to which sigma minimum, the sigma max plus sigma min by 2, you will get min stress. And amplitude means this sigma A, you will get sigma max minus sigma minimum by 2. But such a problem, when components subjected to fluctuating and alternating stresses are solved by using Goodman diagram, or you can say modified Goodman diagram. Try to understand. So while solving the problem or while designing the component, you have to take the lot of care. You have to check it whether component subjected to fluctuating or alternating stress. Then what would be the criteria? That criteria of solving such a problem is the modified Goodman diagram. Try to understand. And I will discuss this topic, the tomorrow or day after tomorrow, how to design the component subjected to fluctuating or alternating stresses. This is one case. Then another one I have already discussed. Today we are going to give the more focus on this topic. When components subjected to reverse stresses, how to design this component? This is the, the main objective of today's session. And I have already explained this reverse stress sinusoidal model also. So you will find on y-axis stress, then x-axis, that is time. So you will find in reverse stress, sigma min, min means M-E-A-N. Not minimum, mean, sigma mean is equal to zero. This is sigma A, stress amplitude, stress amplitude. And a half cycle here, is maybe tensile, half maybe compressive one, and it's a complete reverse cycle. Look at this here. This is one complete cycle. Out of this half stress or half cycle, it consists of tensile stresses and half consists of compressive stresses. And this generally tensile stresses are considered positive and compressive stresses are considered negative one. And when the statement is like this, when component subjected to reverse stresses, that reverse stresses or reverse load of 50 Newton, that means plus minus 50 Newton. Plus means here tensile stress 50, compressive stress 50, that's why plus minus 50 reverse. That means after one cycle again it is going to happen, or component is going to subject the same load. But in reverse stress, as zero mean stress, try to remember these things. And today, if component subjected to such a type of load or reverse stresses or reverse load, how to design such a components, that we are going to see today. Try to understand. That means in fluctuating load topic, you have a two cases. One is design for alternating or fluctuating stresses, and design for reverse stresses or reverse load. Try to understand. And for reverse load, sigma mean, again here sigma mean is equal to zero. And how to design the component when subjected to reverse stress, let us see. Now here again, I have already last time we have discussed the material failure mechanism. There are three things. When component subjected to static load, I have already explained, for ductile material SYT is the criteria, for brittle material SUT is the criteria. You can use simple equation and find out the stresses induced in the component. For fatigue failure, again here the small crack propagates from the inside, and when it reaches to the on the surface, that time the failure which is going to happen, even though in fatigue failure there is no alarm or warning before its failure, that's why fatigue failure is also a sudden and total like a brittle failure. But here the crack propagates from the inside, and when it reaches to the surface, that time failure has already occurred. And this the fatigue failure may be discontinuities, irregularities, scratches, surface roughness, inspection marks, you know very well all the things I have already explained. And we are focusing on this topic now today, on fatigue failure. Now here, now case, when component subjected to reverse load or reverse stresses, if you have a notebook with you, you can write down. So there are two type of problems. When component subjected to completely reverse stresses, these problems are divided into two groups. One group is designed for infinite life, designed for finite life. What do you mean by infinite life and what do you mean by finite life? We have seen in design against static load, how much the stress is going to induce in it, or while determining some of the dimensions of the components by using the simple equations. That time we have designed the component for a infinite life. Infinite life means that the maximum stress induced component, and that we are going to determine, and accordingly we are finding out its size or dimensions, that the dimension can sustain that induced stress. That is the case for design for infinite. In as usual, is like a design against static loading. Then second one is the design for finite. Finite life means how many number of cycles or how much period of time that component can sustain. That means here, when component subjected to reverse load or reverse stresses, there are two cases. First one, you have to check it whether the design for infinite life or whether to design a component for a finite life. Now two cases, let us see one by one case. Now case number one, what is the case one? Design for infinite life. Now when component subjected to reverse loading or reverse stress, how to design the component for infinite life? And for that purpose, endurance limit is the criteria of failure. Try to remember these things. In static load condition, for ductile material SYT is the criteria, for brittle material SUT is the criteria, but for reverse loading and design for infinite life, endurance limit is the criteria. That means we have to determine endurance limit or endurance strength of the component or the material. Try to understand. So you can note down here, design for infinite life, when component subjected to reverse stresses, that time, what is the criteria? Endurance limit is the criteria. And how to find out the endurance limit? Yesterday we have seen, if it's by using a rotating beam machine also you can use it, or second approach is approximate estimation method. And according to approximate estimation method, what is the formula? SE is equal to KA into KB into KC into KD into SE dash. And again, SE dash is equal to 0.5 SET for steel, or cast steel SE dash is equal to 0.4 SUT. That means which type of material used for the component, accordingly you can find out SE dash. And SE dash is the endurance limit of standard specimen or test specimen, try to understand. So that means what you have to do, the endurance limit is the criteria. And how to find out endurance limit SE? I have already explained by using the expression SE is equal to K into KB into KC into KD into SE dash. You will get SE. Now once you will get the SE, so you have to check here. This induced stress should be, what is important in this case, it should be lower than the endurance limit that determine here by using approximate estimation to sustain the infinite number of cycle. Infinite means we are not deciding how much, you know, the life of that the machine element or the component it is going to sustain. And for that purpose, we are checking based on this endurance limit or endurance strength, try to understand. And for that purpose, first of all, find out the SE by using approximate estimation method, or SAC, where component subjected to reverse torsional loading. And yesterday I have already explained SAC is equal to 0.5 SE according to maximum shear stress theory, and according to distortion energy theory, SAC is equal to 0.577 SE. So you can accordingly substitute this value of SAC. Then FOS, factor of safety, may be given for the given application. Accordingly, you can put the factor of safety, you will get sigma a, and you can use this sigma a, that is the stress amplitude, to find out the diameter of the or dimensions of the component. Suppose one rod which is subjected to some load and subjected to reverse stresses and designed for infinite life. But how you are going to find out? The first of all, you have to find out the SE, that is equal to K into KB into KC into KD into SE dash. SE dash means, again, for that material, what is the SUT? Accordingly, you can substitute, if it's made up of steel, 0.5 SUT, you will get SE. Then FOS may be given, or you can take from the data book, you can substitute SE by FOS, you will get sigma A. This is the stress amplitude you can use again further to find out the dimension. Suppose it's a cylindrical rod, sigma is equal to force upon area. The subjected load may be given, that is reverse load. And that load divided by pi by 4 into D square, you sigma A is equal to that load upon pi by 4 into D square, you will get the diameter of the rod. In this way, you can solve the problem for the design for infinite life. That means we are finding out the endurance limit, and based on that stress amplitude, and that's a stress amplitude or stress induced should be lower than the endurance limit to sustain for infinite number of cycle. It's like, you know, the static loading cases. But what is the criteria? Endurance limit is the criteria. And if component is subjected to reverse torsion, that time tau A plays important role. Tau is that you have to point out, tau is equal to SAC upon FOS, where SAC is equal to point, if according to maximum shear stress theory, SAC is equal to 0.5 SE, and SE is equal to K into KB into KC into KD into SE dash, try to understand. Then you can substitute these values here, FOS, you will get tau A. You can use this tau A to find out the other dimensions, right? This is about the design for infinite life. It's a simple, by using simple these two equations and approximate estimation method of this SE and relationship between SAC and SE, you can easily find out the dimensions of the component when subjected to reverse stress, and you can design component easily for infinite life. This is about the case number one, very simple one. I hope you understand it properly. Now let us see the case number two. Case number two means design for finite life. Now when component is subjected to reverse loading or reverse stress, but we have to design it for finite life. Finite life means number of cycles, number of revolutions that we have to, or how much period of time that component can sustain, that we have to find out. for reverse loading case, that time what is the criteria? S N curve is the criteria to find out the number of cycles, or for number of cycles, how much is the stress going to induce in the component. Try to understand the case. In case number two, design for finite life, what is the criteria? S N curve is the criteria. Try to remember. If you have a notebook, you can note down. Here two cases. First one is the fluctuating and alternating stress when component subjected. Modified Goodman diagram is the criteria. Second one, reverse loading. There are two types, design for finite life, design for infinite life. For infinite life, what is the criteria? Endurance limit. And you can use simple equation associated with endurance limit. And you design for finite life, what is the criteria for reverse loading? SN curve is the criteria. You can note down these points. Because while solving the problem also, you have to take the care, you have to read the problem statement carefully, whether they are asking for finite life or infinite life. Accordingly, you can use appropriate, you know, the approach or the method that you have to follow. The second case is design for finite life. When component subjected to reverse loading or design for finite life, SN curve is the criteria. That means by using a SN curve, we are going to find out the stress which is in the component or number of cycles that component can sustain. And you know very well, I have already discussed these things with you. The SN curve is the graphical representation of maximum applied stress versus number of cycle on log paper. Try to understand. And before the particular, that is important. And all these are the points, or the, you know, the pillar points are shown, and through that one line is drawn, or average curve is drawn. This curve is known as the SN curve. And you know very well one y axis, that is applied stress. Again, on log paper means log to the base 10 SF, and x axis log to the base 10 N. N means number of cycles. Again, here while constructing what care you have to take. Here I have already explained. Once again, I will recap these things. Suppose for ferrous material or steel, you will find it contains the iron, the low cycle fatigue and the high cycle fatigue. Up to 0 to 3, it's a low cycle fatigue. Up to 3 to 8, it's a high cycle fatigue. You know very well. And here again, material is having ultimate tensile strength is the maximum stress limit of or any material, and that's why you can locate for this zero cycle here. Maximum one is SUT, and after that up to 10 raised to 6 here. I have already explained that for a steel or a ferrous material, it becomes a constant here. Look at this, or asymptotic, it becomes constant at 10 raised to 6. And when you are going to take log to the base 10, 10 raised to 6, you will get this value 6. Or where, when you are going to take here also, 10 log to the base 10, 10 raised to 3, you will get here 3. Accordingly, you can construct the diagram. But important thing here, what is happening while constructing the curve? Instead of going for a SUT is the maximum limit, after that component is going to fail. That's why while constructing it, what you have to do, and always low cycle. Again, I have already explained low cycle fatigue here, that means component subjected up to 10 raised to 3, by taking a higher value of FOS and using the simple equations of the stresses, you can design the component. No need to go for the fluctuating stress or endurance limit. That's why forget about up to 0 to up to 10 raised to 3 cycles. When component subjected to reverse load or fluctuating load, from 10 raised to 3 to up to 10 raised to 8 plays important role. That's why your SN curve should be in between 10 raised to 3 to up to 10 raised to 6 or up to 10 raised to 8. Try to understand. That's why, while constructing it, don't take directly SUT is the maximum value of the stress for the material. Always less than this, because if it is going to reach, component is going to fail. That's why here for 10 raised to 3, the here this value is 0.9 SUT. You have to reduce by 10%. Try to understand. So accordingly, you can construct the another SN curve while solving the diagram here. Now we are look at this, how to construct it. Now before solving, going for the problem here, look at this. So that's why I have changed this diagram here. Now look at this, on x-axis, again, number of cycles, and it's on a log paper, log to the base 10 N. And why? Try to understand this diagram, because many times while solving the problem, you have to use it. And why axis, it's a stress locked to the base 10 asset. Look at it. First of all, I am going to locate the point for a ferrous or a steel material. Look at this. Your 10 raised to 3 cycle means log to the base 10, 10 raised to 3 means 3 here, you will get the point. But for that, you have to locate first point. Which point? Log to the base 10.9 SUD. You can note down there. The first coordinate is, that is 3 on x axis and 1 y axis, log to the base 10.9 SUD. You will get some value here. You can locate this value here. This point here you are going to locate. Then second point, it's or coordinate is 6. 6 means 10 raised to 6 cycle. Log to the base 10, 10 raised to 6, you will get 6 value here. Again, what you have to do, you can extend these lines from this where this, you know, the point, or you can say for the ferrous or steel material, it becomes a constant. Through that, you have to construct this line. That's point B is having a coordinate 6. Second coordinate is endurance limit, that is log to the base 10 SC. Right under the, or even though you can look at here the coordinate here, if I would like to write here, you can write here coordinate. What is the coordinate? 6, and second coordinate is log to the base 10 SE, or you can say directly SC, this coordinate here. So you will get this here SE, and SE you will get from approximate estimation method, that is K into KB into KC into KD into SC dash, you will get SC. So you can locate log to the base 10 SC and 10 raised to 6. This is SC. That means here you can find out this point. You can locate 0.9 SUT material may be given, and you know this coordinate. And here in finite life problem, sometimes component subjected to the stress may be given. That means SF may be given. And accordingly, you can come to this point and find out here the number of cycle or N, or sometimes find out the stress in the component for number of cycles. That means this log to the base 10 N value of N may be given 90,000 cycle or something. You can take log to the base 10 90,000. You can locate these points and find out this. That means sometimes this point you can find out the stress. In this way, you can do this activity here. Try to understand. That means here what you have to do, so here you are going to construct S anchor. And to construct S anchor, what is the requirement? First coordinate is 3, x axis, you know how to write the coordinate x and y. X means 3, y coordinate means 0.9 SUT. Second coordinate is 6, and what is this? SE. And then to find out number of cycles for the given stress, or for the number of cycle find out the stress, vice versa, no problem. You can locate anywhere these points according to the number of cycles, that is the requirement for finite life. Accordingly, you can locate these points and find out it. So to find out the stress or the number of cycles, again two coordinates are given here, and third coordinate that you have to find out. Out of this third coordinate, one parameter may be, or one coordinate may be given in terms of stress or in terms of number of cycles, another coordinate that you have to find out. You can consider, suppose this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2, and this is suppose x and y. How to find out? This is the line. You can use the equation of line also to find out this x and y, or simply you can say it's interpolation. You can use interpolation method to find out these points. Or in finite life problem, when components subjected to reverse load, what is the criteria? S anchor is the criteria. But while constructing the S anchor, first of all, you have to find out 0.9 SUT1 coordinate for 3. Then for 6, SE may be given. If not given, you can use approximate estimation method, locate these points, and then find out number of cycles for the given stress limit, or for a number of cycles, find out the stress induced in the component, vice versa. In this way, you can design for finite life. This is the part. Now let us see how to solve the problem. It will give the more focus how to use the method. Now I have taken this problem from, I have written here reference also, VB1, all these are the solved problems. Try to understand. On page number 162, it's given. It's the problem of finite life I have written, but while solving it in examination, it's not mentioned. that time you have to check it whether it's a finite life problem or it's a infinite life problem. Try to understand. Now I am going to read the problem statement. Kindly give attention towards this problem. It will give the lot of idea to you how to solve the problem. Look at this. I am going to read the statement. Rotating bar made of steel. Steel is given. 40C8 material. That is plain carbon steel. SUT is also given. Is subjected to complete reverse bending. Completely reverse means it's a problem of reverse stress. Try to understand. It's a problem of reverse stress. The corrected endurance limit. Now here, corrected endurance limit of the bar is 315 or 315 newton per mz. That means endurance limit SE is also given directly, 315 newton per mz. Calculate the fatigue strength. That means endurance limit of the bar for life of 90,000 cycles. Life is given means N is given. What you have to do? Calculate fatigue strength means you have to find out the fatigue strength of the bar for number of cycles 90,000. So I am going, first of all, read the problem statement. Steel is given. SUT is given. Again, it's a problem of reverse, completely reverse bending. That means it's a reverse bending. And here they are asking you to calculate fatigue strength for a life. That means it's a life or finite life problem. Try to understand. Look at this life of 90 cycles. That means it's a finite life problem. So first of all, note down, it's a completely reverse bending. Stress means reverse loading problem. Second one is they are asking to find out fatigue strength for this life means finite life problem. First of all, you have to note down these 2 points. And then whatever the given data, you can write down. So what is the given data? SUT, ultimate tensile strength is given 630 newton per mm square. Then SE is also given, endurance limit of the bar 350. Newton per mm square, number of cycles n 90,000 cycles. What you have to do? Find out the fatigue strength of the bar. How to find out? Now looking or reading this problem statement in your mind, it's a finite life problem and reverse loading problem. So what is the criteria? S anchor is the criteria. Try to understand. Finite life, reverse loading, S anchor is the criteria. Now let us construct S anchor. And for that purpose, for the construction of S anchor, what is the required coordinate? I have already explained. This is X axis locked to the base 10 N. This is Y axis locked to the base 10 SF. The first coordinate, what you have to do? I have already explained in earlier slides also. The first one, log paper. That's why first coordinate is here. X axis 3 and Y axis is equal to 0.9 SU to these points. This point is nothing but a log to the base 10, 0.9 SUT. Try to understand. You can note down here. 0.9 SUT, this point is. So first of all, find out 0.9 SUT. SUT is given in problem, that is 630. The 0.9 into 630, you will get 5,6,7. And if I am going to take its log, look at this, log to the base 10, 0.9 SUT. The log to the base 10, 5,6,7, you will get 2.73. 7536, you can look at this point here. 2.7536 is this point, and this point is nothing but log to the base 10.9 SUT. Try to understand. That means I have located first coordinate. Then what's about the second coordinate? Second means at 10 raised to 6, vertically you have to go and horizontally you have to locate SE. This is SE. So what is SE? SE is also given in problem statement, that is 315. So log to the base 10 SE. That is 2.4983. So locate here at 10 raised to 6, where it becomes constant. You can locate this point is SE, or you can say log to the base 10 SE. The log to the base 10 SE means 2.498. I have located this another coordinate. So what we have to do in this problem statement, they have asked you what is the fatigue stress for number of cycle. How many number of cycle? 90,000 cycle. Now, the first of all, what you have to do? The one x-axis number of cycles. So we have to, it's a log paper. The first of all, find out log to the base 10 of 90,000 cycle. You will get 4.95. 4.95 means nearer to this 5. So what you have to do? So you can locate these points here. log to the base 10, 90,000 cycle. You will get 4.9542. You can look at this point on x-axis. Look at this here. It's a 4.9514. Through that, you can draw the line vertically up where it cuts to this S anchor. This point horizontally, you can look at. This point we have to find out, or the fatigue strength or fatigue stress that we have to determine. It is in between these two, 2.7.2.49, or this is 0.9 SU10, this is log to the base 10 SE. This value we have to find out, or you can say this point is nothing but a log to the base 10 SF dash that we have to determine. Try to understand. I hope you are getting this, how to locate this. Sometimes this stress value may be given. You can find out log to the base 10 this value and find out here log to the base 10 N and then N. By taking anti-log, you will get number of cycles. Right. Now again here, look at this line. This point is having, look at the cursor. This point is having two coordinate. Which coordinate? 6. And second one is 2.4983. Again, this point is having two coordinate. One is 3, 2.7536. And now this point is having two coordinate. One is 4.9542 and second coordinate is SF. We have to find out SF. That means for this line, how to find out this? So you have to use the slope. It's a line or slope equation also you can use it, or directly you can go for the interpolation. You know very well. If three coordinate here, x1, x2. y1, y2, and here x and y are given. How to call, look at this coordinate? You know very well this, the equation, you know, the slope equation that we are going to use it for that purpose. Suppose these equations are given, you know, the y minus y1 upon x minus x1 is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. And even though in numerical methods you are studying this topic, there is interpolation is one of the topic, you know very well. Even though in applied thermodynamics also you might have studied by referring the steam table also, how to take the value of, you know, the enthalpy HS XFG by using, you know, the steam tables also. You know very well how to use the interpolation. And here, once you know all these points, so we have to find out this SF dash. And how to find out this? I have used here interpolation. And after doing this interpolation, you will get the value of SF. The same equation here, it is written, is used. And by using this equation, you will get log to the base 10 SF is equal to 2.573. Here, this point, log to the base 10 SF is equal to 2.5. After using this interpolation, and then once again, what you have to do is the log 10 SF. So you can take anti-log. Anti-log of this, so you will get 386. That means you will get for 90,000 cycle, the fatigue strength is equal to 386.63. This is about the finite life problem by using S anchor. Now in this problem, directly you see, you know, the endurance limit, corrected endurance limit is given. Sometimes that you have to determine by using approximate estimation method also. This is about the finite life problem. Now look. The second simple problem, that is infinite life problem. Now here, what you have to do, I am going to read this problem. A rod of linkage mechanism made of steel 40 chromium 1, that means alloy steel is used, SUT 550 Newton per mm square, is subjected to a completely reverse axial load of 100 kilonewton. The rod is machined on lathe and expected reliability is 95%. There is no stress concentration. Determine the diameter of the rod using factor of safety of 2 for an infinite life condition. I mean, first of all, always read problem statement carefully. You have to spend 1 or 2 minutes. Now in this problem statement, the linkage mechanism is given, which is made up of steel 40 chromium 1. SUT is also given. You can note down this, all this point in given data, SUT 550. And now here, interesting or important thing, subjected to completely reverse axial load. Reverse stress, right under, reverse axial load. Again, yesterday I have already discussed when components subjected to reverse loading, that time what you have to do? When it is subjected to reverse loading, that time You have to reduce the endurance limit by 20% or SE axial is equal to 0.8 SE. Yesterday we have already discussed this point. The reverse is plays important role. That means it's a reverse loading problem, and here infinite life condition. That means this problem is infinite and reverse load. So what is the criteria? The simple equation of SE. Sigma A is equal to SA upon FOS or SAC upon FOS to get the tau. This is the criteria. Try to understand. Or endurance limit is the criteria. Now note down all the given data. The first of all, SUT is given 550 Newton per mm square. Then axial load 100 kilonewton is given. It's a reverse, means plus minus you can see, because in reverse loading again, you know, cycle plus half cycle minus, that may be tensile and compressed. Reliability 95% is given. FO is also given too. Now here I have written KD1. Why? There is no stress concentration. You know very well what is the expression to find out SE. According to approximate estimation, SE is equal to K into KB into KC into KD into SE dash. But if there is no stress concentration, the KD factor is equal to 1 upon KF. KF is the fatigue stress concentration factor. If no stress concentration factor, means KD is equal to 1. So that's why I have written here KF is equal to 1. Therefore, KD is equal to 1 upon 1, or you can say directly there is no effect of stress concentration. That's why KD is equal to 1. So only three factors remaining: K, KB, KC. And there is no thermal, you know, the things, temperature factor is not given, miscellaneous factor is not given. That's why no need to consider it. The only what is the remaining three factors: K, surface finish factor; KB, size factor; KC, reliability factor. We have to find out SE. And once you will get the SE, we can consider the axial load. We can reduce it by 20%. The SE axial is equal to 0.8 SE, and we are going to find out the diameter. How to find out? Let us see. After writing all these things, the first of all, in problem statement, it is given here. What is given? Rod is machine on lathe. It's a machine. Manufacturing process is machine. The vane surface is machine. An ultimate tensile strength is given. How much? 550 Newton per second. So I am going to show here yesterday how to take the value of K. I have already explained. You can refer this chart or a graph. The one x-axis tensile strength, one y-axis surface finish factor K are given. So you can look at here. For this problem, what is phi-u? How much is the? This is phi-u 100 and phi-u 50 is given. SUT. So you can look at one x-axis phi-u 50. Here you can again. Rod is machine. So you can refer this line, machine and cauldron. It's a machine line. So I am going to locate for 550 SUT. Line is selected, machine. Here you will get this point. You can locate it is less than 0.8. Accordingly, I am, otherwise you can use this expression if it's given. Try to understand. Now here for SUT 550 and machine surface, you will get K less than 0.8, means 0.78. from this graph you can easily observe it's a 0.78. this value I am going to take K is equal to. This is about K. How to select the KB? KB means size factor. But in this case, what we have to do? We have to find out the diameter of the rod. We don't know the diameter. That means we don't know the value of D. And in such a time, what you have to do? You can assume the diameter of the rod. And that's why here in this problem, I am going to assume diameter, because you know the 7.5 or less than 7.5 for standard specimen, you know very well. You can assume generally the diameter of the rod, it is in between 7.5 to 50. It's your choice. Assuming diameter in between 7.5 to in between 50 mm. And how to take the value of this KB? Again, yesterday I have explained to you, you can report this table. When diameter is less than 7.5, KB is equal to 1. In between 7.5 to 50, it's 0.85, and greater than 50, 0.75. But assuming it is in between 7.5 to 50, it's 0.85. So substitute this value. So assuming It is in between 7.5 to 50 take KB 0.85. A reliability is given. How much? 95. Again, yesterday I have shown one table to you for a reliability of 95%. How much is the value of KC? 0.868. You can refer this. And in examination or SPP, they have to provide the table to you or directly all these reliability. Accordingly, you can solve the problem. You will get reliability for 95%. KC is equal to 0.868. By taking this value of KC, look at this here, KC. Now you have all the values, KA, KB, KC. What you have to do? You can use this expression. SE is equal to K into KB into KC into KD into K into AC dash. But KD is equal to 1. Thermal factor or miscellaneous is not given. That's why K is equal to 1. Only K you can substitute 0.78 here. KB 0.85 here. KC 0.868 here. And what is AC dash? It's made up of steel material. For steel, AC dash is equal to 0.5 SET. You can substitute 0.5 SET means 550. You will get 275. You can substitute this value here. So you will get the expression SE is equal to KA into KB into KC into AC dash. And K is equal to this 0.78, KB 0.85, AC 0.868, and AC dash means 275. You can substitute, you will get SE. The SE is equal to 158.26 Newton per mm. Once you will get this value, it's a but here in reverse, which load? Axial load. And yesterday I have told for axial loading, SEA is equal to 0.8 SE. So first of all, find out 0.8 SE. The 0.8 into this SE 158.26, so you will get SEA axial 126. And once you will get this, you have to use the simple equation because it's a problem of infinite life case of reverse loading. The sigma A is equal to SEA upon FOS. The SEA 126 upon FOS, how much? 2. You will get sigma A is equal to 63.5. And in reverse load is given simple equation, sigma is equal to force upon area. Therefore, you can use it this equation or force is equal to this area into sigma A. The sigma A is equal to 63.5, area pi by 4 into D square. P means subjected to axial load of plus minus how much? It is given in problem statement, 100 kilonewton. So you can substitute 100 into 10 raised to 3. Sigma A, 63.5. So what you have to do, find out D. You will get D is equal to 44.8 or something equal to 45. In this way, you can solve the infinite life problem. So what we have done, we have calculated SE. Before that, we have selected these modifying factors from the charts or the formulas. And there is no stress concentration, that's why I assume 1. After calculating SE, axial loading case, that's why I reduce 0.8 SE. Then again, it's infinite problem. That's why I use this equation, sigma A, SE upon FOS. You will get sigma A. And as usual, equation of sigma A is equal to force upon area. Find out diameter of this rod of the linkage, that is 45. This is about the infinite life problem or reverse load. But today we have seen two cases, reverse loading, finite case life problem, reverse loading, infinite life problem. For a finite case, S and curve is the criteria. For infinite life, simple equation and endurance limit is the criteria. Try to understand. This is about the reverse loading, finite and infinite life problem. Thank you. I have referred Vivi Bhandari's book, Design of Machine Element. If you have any query, you can contact us or directly WhatsApp us at 9890426679 or mail me at pbkushari@kkwag.edu.in. Thank you. Thank you. This is about today's session. Thank you.